So hello guys, welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to talk about the quality control. It is the first part of the video where we will talk about introduction to the quality, historical evolution of total quality of management, concept of TQM, and also philosophy of total quality of management, principles of total quality of management, tools and components of total quality of management, cost of quality, quality control, objectives of quality control, advantages and benefits of quality control, statistical quality control or SQC, and statistical process control, which is controlling chart, where there is control chart for the variables and control charts for attributes. Now talking, and also we include topics like JIT, just in time, control charts for variables like X chart and R chart, and control chart for attributes P chart, NP chart, and C chart. Now introduction to quality. The excellent product service that fulfills the expectation. It is the quality refers to the ability of the product to meet the requirement and expectation. Quality is the customer dependent. It is tangible based on the perception. It can be quantified as Q is equals to P by E, where P refers to the performance and E refers to expectation. Now definitive definition. So definitive definition of quality is given in ISO 9000:2000. So it is defined as the degree to which the set of inherent characteristics fulfills the requirement. So the degree means the quality used as poor, good, excellent. Inherent means something as permanent characteristics. Quality is relative term used with the reference to end user of product. The process of identifying and administrating activities needed to achieve the quality objectives of the organization. Now talking about historical evolution of total quality of management. So it consists of organization wide effort to install and make the permanent climate in which organization continuously improves its ability to define the high quality product to the customer. Total quality of management draws heavily on previously developed tools and techniques of the quality control. First, there is inspection. So it involves measuring, examining, testing the products and services against the specified requirement to determine the conformity. Inspection is used to decide whether the worker's job produce product met the requirement. Inspection is done in order to ensure no product is left factory, focus on product, detect problem, and carry out the production process. Now we have quality control or statistical theory. So quality control was first introduced to detect and fix the problem to prevent the production of faculty product. So statistical theory played an important role in this area, eliminating the variation in the process lead to good standard high-end product. Quality control, it focuses on the product detection and control of the quality, testing samples of all the product. Next is quality in Japan. So Japanese products are perceived as cheap and shoddy imitation. They aim to learn how they can achieve quality aim. They achieve their goals in 5 years. So quality circle is the volunteer group of the workers who meet and discuss the issue to improve the every aspect of the workplace and make the presentation to the management with their ideas. The employees' motivation and ideas of improving the quality of the product and organization issue is byproduct of quality circle. Now we have total quality. So the first termed in International Conference of Quality Control in Tokyo in 1969, it means the company-wide quality control that involves employees, forms the top management to workers in quality control. Total quality in management, it is known as the total quality management TQM. It is typical definition of TQM includes the phrases like customer focus, involvement of employees, continuous improvement, integration of quality management. Next we have business excellence. So TQM is the often called the business excellent model. It is distinguished as new total quality management from the past work of TQM. So business improvement program was also called TQM. Concept and definition of total quality in management. So it is an enhancement to the traditional way of doing business. It is proven technique to guarantee the survival in the world-class competition. TQM is the art of managing the whole to achieve the excellence. TQM is a measure decent development in production and operations management. It is never ending quest to improve the quality of the output as Kaizen or continuous improvement. So some of the key elements of TQM includes top management, commitment, customer involvement and focus, and quality culture. Now TQM is the philosophy and a set guiding principles that represents the foundation of continuous improvement. The main approaches of TQM are never ending push to the improve Kaizen, involvement of everyone in the organization, and goals of customer satisfaction, meeting the customer expectation. Now philosophy of TQM, there is leadership concept, customer satisfaction, employee involvement, continuous improvement, performance measurement, benchmarking. Now talking first about leadership concept. So leadership requires intuitive understanding of human nature. To make it effective, leaders should understand people need security and independence. People are sensitive to external reward and punishment. People trust their gut's reaction rather than statistical data. Leaders' characters and competence is developed by good habits and ethics. So customer satisfaction. So TQM implies organization obsession with exceeding customer expectation. It understands customer needs and expectation is essential to win new business and keep existing business. The reasonable price includes on-time delivery, outstanding service, as well as to be competitive, it is essential to examine the quality system if they are responsive to change, customer requirement and expectation. Now next, there is employee involvement. Employee involvement improves the quality and increase the productivity as they make better decision, implement and support decision, better to spot the area of improvement, create morale by feeling of belongingness, increase the commitment towards organizational goal. Continuous improvement, which includes quality based organization, achieve the perfection by continuously improving the business and the production process. Improvement is made by making effective and efficient adaptable processes, anticipating changing customer needs, maintaining the constructive dissatisfaction, eliminating waste and network, benchmarking to improve competitive advantage. Now performance measurement. Performance measure is used to achieve the objectives like establish baseline measures, determine the process need to be improved, indicate the gains and losses, compare the goals with actual performance, provide information for the individual and team evaluation. And lastly, we have benchmarking. It is the systematic method by which organization measures themselves against the best industry practice. It promotes superior performance by providing organized framework in which organization learns to do the best and learns how the practices are different and implement the changes to close the gap. It is the process of borrowing the idea and adapting them to gain the competitive advantage. Now principles of TQM, it focus on customer strategic approach to improvement, improving continuously, employee involvement, encourage mutual respect and teamwork, role of top management, and early detection of defects. Now first talking about focus on customer, it involves designing goods and services that meets the customer expectation. It involves product, its function, attributes and convenience. Marketing department is responsible to get the cyber world out to the potential client using the social networking and email texting. IT department and research and development department make changes immediately. Strategic approach to improvement. So the process developed and tested to measure the goods and services quality. It involves making sure supplier quantity supply needed to produce goods. Purchasing department monitor the client review to determine whether rating on the website is similar to the particular past customer. It adopts a strategic approach towards the quality improvement to achieve the goal, aim, vision and mission. Next we have improving continuously. So it is analyzing the way of work is being performed to determine if more effective or efficient way for making the improvement and striving for the excellence. The HR department interested in making the sure employees they are qualified to perform their job. Qualified and trained employees run organization effectively. We have now employee involvement. So total employee involvement in achieving the goals and business objectives. leads to the employee empowerment and active participation from the employees in decision making and addressing the quality related problems. Employee empowerment and involvement can be increased by making the workspace more open and avoid the fear. Now, encourage mutual respect and teamwork. So it fosters single organization culture of excellence by knowing every employee from the top to bottom level in hierarchy. The entire team work together to make a view, plan and book with easy experience. It requires inter-department approach to total quality in management. And lastly, we have role of top management. So top management is responsible for ensuring the company produces product of superior quality. The top management creates organizational structure, product design process and process design facilitates for the production of the product of superior quality. And now we have early detection of defects. So defective product must be identified as soon as possible. It can be rectified before producing another defective product. In process, product must be simplified and employee must have self-respect in their outputs. Now last we have tools and components of total quality of management, which includes check sheet, histogram, Pareto chart, scatter diagram and control chart. Now talking first about check sheet, it presents information in efficient and graphic format. It is accomplished with the simple listing of the item. Next we have histogram. It provides simple graphical view of accumulated data including this person and central tendency. The strength of histogram is that it provides easy to read picture of the location. Now we have Pareto chart. It is useful to identify the factors that have highest cumulative effects on the system, screen out the less significant factors in analysis and create by plotting the cumulative frequency of relative frequency data in descending order. Next we have a scatter diagram, where the graphical tool data are used that influence one variable on another. And lastly we have control chart. It is the fundamental tool of statistical process control, SPC. It indicates the range of variability that is built into the system, known as the common cause variation. Now cost of quality. Now talking in difference of category, description and some of the example. Now we have appraisal cost or unprocessing cost. It is the cost related to measuring, evaluating, auditing parts, products, services that is excess conforms with the quality standards. So example can be inspection equipment, testing labs, inspectors, interruptions of the production. Next we have prevention cost and pre-processing cost. So it is the cost related to reducing the potential for the quality problem. So the example can be quality improvement program, training, monitoring and data collection. Next we have internal failure cost, where it is the cost related to the defective product before they are delivered to the customer. For example, rework cost, problem solving, material loss and scrap. And lastly, we have external failure cost, which is the cost related to delivering sub-standard product. Example like returned goods, reworking cost, warranty cost, and loss of goodwill and penalty. Now, quality control. Quality control provides product which are dependable and satisfactory, economical. It is the process to measure the output relative to the standard and take corrective action when it does not meet the standard. There are four factors which play important role for the quality, which is material. It is the basic source for the quality production. Next is manpower, trained and qualified person increase the efficiency with better quality. Next is machine, where better equipment can result efficient work and reduce the cost defectives. And next we have management, which is effective and efficient management brings control, harmony in relation and growth of business. Now quality of quality control. It is established desired quality standard acceptable to customer. It discovers the flaws and variation. It evaluates the method and process of production and suggests further improvement. It analyzes in detail causes responsible for such deviation. It helps to undertake the steps helpful in achieving the desired quality. Now, advantages and benefits of quality control. It is uniform quality and reliability, reduce the cost of material handling, higher operating efficiency, better utilization of resources, reduce inspection cost, reduce customer complaint, better customer satisfaction. Now statistical quality control, SQC. So it is concerned with the quality of conformance of the process. The manager uses SQC to evaluate the output process to evaluate output of process to determine if it is statistically acceptable. SQC is the application of statistical techniques to accept and reject the product already produced or control process while quality product is produced. Now objectives of SQC is take necessary corrective steps to maintain quality, achieve better quality level, better utilization of raw material, locate and identify process faults, coordinate of standard, and take different measures to improve standard of quality of product. Now we have statistical process control or controlling chart. So control chart is the time order plot of sample statistics where it is used to distinguish between the random variability and non-random variability. So control chart is sampling distribution essentially describes random variability. So first talking about control chart for variables, there is X chart which is used to see whether the process is gathering output consistent with the target value bet by the management for the process, whether the performance is consistent with the past performance. Next we have R chart. R chart is used to monitor the process variability. It calculates the range of the set of sample data. R value indicates the gain or the loss in the dispersion occurred. It is the critical parameter, central tendency and dispersion. Next we have control chart for attributes. The X and R chart no apply when sampling attributes. So there are two attributes control chart. Those measure the percent defective P chart, which measures the number of percent defective NP chart and counts the number of defects, which is C chart. So there are three charts overall: P chart for the percentage, NP for number of percentage, and C for count number of defects. Now talking about P chart, it is used for the performance measures based on the attributes, the performance characteristics counted rather than measured. The item is declared good or defective. For example, bank industry number of incorrect financial statement to the customer, they give yes or no decision. Nominal distribution gives approximation. Next we have NP chart. It is the modified form of P chart in which number of defects are used instead of fraction defectives. It shows the actual number of defects, making it convenient and meaningful. And lastly we have C chart, where service product have more than one defect. Carpeting roll might have defects like discolor, stain and torn. It is a situation in which more than one defect uses the Poisson distribution method. Now just in time, it is made in complete form and developed by Taichi Ono. It is a philosophy rather than a technique. It is both philosophy and integrated system of production and management. By eliminating the wastage working on the continuous improvement, it aims at creating the manufacturing system that is responsive to the market seeds. Now this system operates with a low work in progress inventory with reduced lead time. The concept of JIT is viewed as big JIT and little JIT. Now talking about big JIT, it encompasses the full range of organization and operational improvement practiced by Japanese companies. The philosophy of the operational management that seeks to eliminate the wastage in all the aspects like human relation, vendor relation, technology, management, material, inventory. Next we have little JIT. It is the form of production scheduling and inventory management to meet the actual demand. Material for each state of the production is received and produced. JIT means producing the quantity of unit needs and neither more nor less. It focuses on focusing on them on date and time when required. Now JIT is important for the minimum wastage because it reduces the problem of overproduction, waiting of suppliers and customer, transportation of carriage inward and outward, processing as delay processing, stock as no warehouse or storage, and marketing defects where 0.01% is also not acceptable. Now, what is talking description in description form. So what is JIT? It is the management philosophy. It is pull method of material flow. It is flexible workforce. It is automated production. There is zero inventory and uses less lead time. Now what does JIT does? It attacks wastage. It is the reduction in the size of inventory, reduction of unnecessary cost, improve productivity and avoid overproduction waiting. Now how JIT does? There is employment participation, Kanban system of production, flexible management system, FMS, quality at source and total quality management, TQM. Now what JIT assumes? There is stable environment, low capital, quick response, quality production and good relation. So that's the end of the part one of the topic. We will see you soon in the second part of the video. So make sure you like, comment and subscribe. You guys are amazing. Keep reading.